Hey guys. Ugh.
My headphones have been like in a coiled position for like hours now because I put them down last night, and now the whole thing's curly. So brilliant. And yeah, I'm going to be doing some drawing today. I didn't initially have an idea, I will admit. It was like... Okay, so I didn't originally have an idea, but I knew I wanted to do art. That was the vibe I was getting. I wanted to do art. It's something... like, I wanted to get to do more art streams, you know, for this year, because towards the end of last year, I wasn't doing very many art streams, despite starting on art streams and art streams alone. So we're gonna try and get back into that groove. Didn't initially have an idea, so I kind of plucked something out of thin air that I like the idea of. So it's basically, I draw like a, well, not a mandala, but like a nice pattern stuff, and then I draw like random circles all over, and then only colour in where the circle sits. It's something I've done in like a sketchbook before, and I find it quite fun and somewhat therapeutic, so you know, I figured I'd do it. I'd give it a shot. So yeah. I am also wearing one of the two drawing gloves that I got over the Christmas period. Because I got one for my drawing pad and one for my phone stylus. So I'm currently wearing the smaller one. Because they're both relatively the same size. Only the one for the phone stylus, it sits like half a centimeter off my hand in the split between the two fingers. So it doesn't sit quite right. However, the one for my drawing pad fits perfectly. The only issue I have is that like the wrist is a little big. But you know, that's something I can actually like edit. That's something I can fix. So that's the only issue I have. But then again, some people have like chonky wrists. So who knows, you know? But yeah. Oh, hang on. There we go. The drawing costume. There we go. But yeah. I've already like colored the background just as like a get me inspired sort of thing, because when you have like a plain like blank canvas, like a plain white canvas, it can be a little, not debilitating, but I guess like demotivating in a sense. I think I'm gonna do 9 actually. Set it in the middle. I'm gonna lock it so that it doesn't move around. Do I wanna see it? I think for now I'll go with seeing it. But I'm not gonna go with like going over. So I'm gonna start with a colour actually. Because I've noticed I'm more interested in something that's more colourful than something that is, you know, not. Like, I'm more interested in colour. Damn. That is tiny. That is... I guess I zoomed in a little far, didn't I? But yeah, basically I just wanted to do like something artsy, so I just like took a look through a sketchbook, tried to like find something, I guess. Just so that, you know, I could actually do art on the stream. But obviously it's all like my own like choice. But you know, it's when you have that moment of I want to art but I don't have art in mind. Like you have the motivation, you just don't have the inspiration, you know? Like that. So that's basically what I had this morning, panicking, thinking, oh fuck, what am I gonna do for stream? And then I also had to figure out stream name, which was also a mild nightmare. So, yeah. I'm basically just gonna do flowers and nice looking crap. Just cause, you know, it's nice, you know? But, stuff I've been doing recently. Back to college. That sucks. That sucks ass. It really does. It sucks absolute assetry. Mostly because we were immediately thrown into a project. And the issue is we had like bank holiday Monday. And while that's great for like, oh, it's a like even a day long like thing, we get one more day of holiday. We were thrown into a project that we hadn't been briefed on. Like, we started on Tuesday. And then we had Wednesday off, because that's how like college works. We had like Thursday off, not Thursday, Wednesday. Had Wednesday off and then came back on Thursday, and it wasn't till like the second to last lesson that we were actually briefed on the project that we'd been confused about for like a day and a half already. So, that was a little annoying, I will admit. But, you know, it's just how, like, the lessons were set up. Because we have to be briefed on it by our tutor, and usually we have, like, quite a few lessons with him on a Monday. So they were planning it as if we'd been briefed on the Monday, but unfortunately it was a bank holiday Monday, so couldn't do that. So we were thrown immediately in, and asked by like every teacher we encountered, oh, have you been, do you know what you're doing with like the lantern project? And we're like, fucking what lantern project? And we're getting the same response from all the teachers, oh, like, you haven't been briefed, you don't know what you're doing. No, we have no idea what we're doing. Right, I will get on that, because yikes. None of us had any fucking idea what we were doing. Any idea at all. It was absolute madness trying to get back into the flow of things. Like, absolute madness. Because, like, we'd been off for like 2 weeks. You know, it's one of those things. It's not great, because, you know, you don't remember what the fuck you're doing. Oh boy. I know that some people came here for like art streams last year, Like, I remember someone requesting, like, a Pokemon OC, I think it was. Oh, fuck. Like that. So, it was not great going back. We did have a lot of confusion. We have to complete the lantern project by, I think it was like the 15th of February? Something along those lines. So, not great, I will admit, but, you know, not good enough. Because, like, there's gonna be, like, a festival, I think they said it was. Oh, fuck it, I'll allow it to go over. So they said it was like a festival to celebrate like the area I live in. Ooh, some shiz like that, and I'm like, this town is fucking dumb. Why are you having like a history thing? I don't remember anything significant in like history. In like history class, I never learned anything that encapsulated this town. Like, what fucking history are you talking about? It's dumb. It is, but like, I have no idea what I'm doing with this, I will admit. But it's like, we have to finish the lantern project by 15th of Feb or something. Just because, like, that's when the festival goes off. And it's like, we've been tossed in the fucking deep end. Like, we don't have a goddamn clue what we are doing. Not in the faintest fucking idea of what the hell we're supposed to be doing. But, you know, trying to figure it out while the teachers faff around. Because, you know, teachers do. People are definitely confused with, like, changes to the schedule, like the lessons. Like, people were definitely confused about, like, oh, what are we doing, where are we going, what's going on, because no one was explaining shit to us. So it's all sort of like, we don't know what the hell's going on. What are we doing? And just, like, leaping for the next best thing. Like, we had to pick, like, a bird or an insect of, like, local wildlife to, like, make into a lantern. Which, that's all well and good. But it's a giant lantern. It is being made out of willow and tissue paper. And my fucking group chose a dragonfly. Dragonfly is gonna be kinda difficult. I'm going to admit, it's not going to be an easy path to take. So, like, I'm not doing this with my drawing pad, by the way. I'm doing this, like, touch screen as I have done last year. Because I'm still not really familiar with the actual pad itself. I'm really not. Like, I've only used it about twice. Because, like, I tend to draw downstairs if I'm not doing streaming. So, I don't want to bring it downstairs. In case, you know, my dog damages it. In case, like, I can't use it properly. Like, because I won't have a place to, like, set it on. You know? It's kind of annoying. Okay. That looks nice so far. Alright. But it's been a mess of crap recently. A mess of crap. I also found, like, I've also been, like, looking through, like, YouTube for stuff, and I found, Lavender Town's comic, like, her comic Unfamiliar, her little comic / webtoon, lost my train of thought. Oh, that's unsurprising. I tend to do that a lot. Yeah, I found her comic. It's like 227 parts. I managed to read it in like a whole evening. But it's interesting. I like it. It's on Tapas, I think. The site Tapas. I think they have like a mobile version, like an app for the actual stuff, and it's cute. It's definitely her style. It's got an interesting premise to it, because it's just about like a little witch who moves to a new town, and she gets a house but doesn't realize that it's actually like haunted, so it's actually got like ghosty boys in it. But it's like it's got loads of ghosts, so she has to, with the help of friends, she has to find the ways to help the ghosts find their peace, you know, and let them move on in the world. So, like, I know there's, like, a bride ghost, so they make up, like, a whole wedding. There's no groom. there's no groom, but they set up a wedding for her because she didn't get the wedding she wanted, which is kind of sad. It's basically, she was in an arranged marriage and went missing in like the woods. So she wanted a wedding to give her the wedding she'd wanted, because she'd been imagining it as a child, and then she got into an arranged marriage with a man that she wasn't really interested in, that she didn't love, and after she disappeared, he married someone else. And she's like, I'm happy he got what he wanted, that he's got his eternal peace, but I haven't, and I want that wedding. So they invite people from all around the area to go to this ghost wedding. And, oh, it's beautiful. I love it. Like, that's just, like, one of like the very, it's like one little thing of quite a few different events. I believe there's four main characters from what I've gathered. But it's very cute and very sweet. Like, some of them are definitely like freakier or have darker premises than others. Like darker backstories, but it's still cute. Like, it's still nice. Like, I'd suggest reading it. I don't really want to give away much, just in case someone does like genuinely want to read it. But, like, I don't want to give too many spoilers, just in case, you know? I have no idea what I'm doing with this. Like, it's nice, it is, but, like, I haven't the faintest fucking clue what I'm doing. Right, so got like most of it done. Like, so I got like the center done. But now I need like more of it. I keep making sure there's like a new layer just in case I have to clear the whole thing so that I don't delete the entire actual drawing itself. What the fuck? Accidentally brought up the keyboard. But yeah, I read Lavender Town's comic and I love it. Like, I've subscribed to it now, so I'll get like updates on it. So she should be doing like one every week, which is a nice idea. And I looked at, because it gives you the dates for when, you know, like a piece was uploaded. It dates back all the way to 2016. All the way back to fucking 2016, man. She has been doing this for a long ass time, and kudos to her for that. Cause I struggle with like keeping on track with like my schoolwork and being inspired to write or to like I struggle with like trying to write and other stuff, like remembering to do the work, being inspired to do the work. It's like, it's, I have inspiration, but then it's very fleeting, so I end up like not doing the thing that I wanted to do. So like, I have an inspiration for a book or something. Like, I have an idea, and then I start writing the idea, and then it's gone. I've written it down, and now I have no motivation to continue with it. You know? So like, kudos to Lavender Town for having like the motivation to continue with doing that sort of thing, because I don't have the strength, like the mental strength or willpower to keep doing that sort of thing. Like, it's sweet. It's very, I don't know the word for it at the moment. I can't think of it, but she's been doing it since 2016. I don't have the willpower to even begin to start a comic because I'm not confident in my artistic ability. Like, I know right now I'm not doing terribly shit, but oftentimes you need characters. Like, genuine, like, full-blown characters with, like, bodies and movement and stuff like that. Obviously, like, a comic standing still, but you still gotta, like, imply movement. And like, these characters have to have a life to them. They have to have a personality, and I'm not great at that. I'm not a particularly great person when it comes to like making a character interesting, I guess. Move the mic a little closer. But I'm not a particularly good person when it comes to like making a character interesting. Like, I'm not actually good at it. Like, I made an 8-year-old cat, more or less. My little hunter. She is my pride and joy. She's an OC that I've actually had for years, that I've actually stuck with, and I'm happy about that. And I wish that I could put that much effort into any other OC I've ever created. Because I'll create an OC, but there'll be nothing behind them. They will simply just be a figure that will most likely never get used. And it's kind of depressing, actually, for me. It's kind of bittersweet, I suppose. Like, there's a bittersweetness to creating an original character when it comes to, like, my own personal experience. Because I create the character. I have an idea, I have a premise, I have an idea for who I want this person to be, and then I never use them. I never end up using them. They end up in the OC trash, per se. In the archives. Because I never use them for anything. I don't have any particular use for them other than just their plain old creation, because I'm bored or I have like no other ideas, that I have no, like, I have no other stuff to do, you know? And it's saddening, actually. The amount of, like, OCs I've created over the years that have been, like, a one-time thing. They're a one-time creation. They're never going to be picked up again. I've given this thing a name, a body. I've given it an existence. And it's never returning. It's never coming back. And I'd love to do something with them, but these things are just taken from, like, bases. Like, I take a base from, like, the actual, like, OC creator chart, or I take, like, a random base from somewhere else to create this OC, and they end up just staying that. A base. Nothing more, nothing less. It's just a creature I created. More or less nothing. And I kind of get upset about that sometimes, because I spend so much time creating them. And then they never end up seeing the light of day. I'd love to do something like Lavender Town to, like, create a comic. But I don't have a consistent art style at all. I don't have motivation most days. I don't even know, like, the basics of creating a comic other than, like, basic, like, speech bubble splitting and stuff like that. Like, I wouldn't know where to start with, like, an actual premise, like, an actual story. And it's bittersweet, because I have the inspiration. I have the motivation to start one. But my self-criticism, like, my negativity, my pessimism, is gnawing at the back of my mind going, why are you trying? Why do you want to do this? You know you can't draw people. You know you can't draw hands. You know you can't do X, Y, Z, A, B, C. Why are you trying? And I'm like, I can do it. And then I start trying and it doesn't come out how I picture it. And then I fucking give up. Because, again, I don't have much willpower. It's pathetic. And I get mad at myself for it. Because I have the motivation and the inspiration, but I can't get the execution. Like, I can't put onto page as I have in my head. Because in my mind, I can draw anatomy. I can do stuff like that. But in reality, like, bring to hand, that's not how it works. And it definitely gives me, like, a slump in my confidence. Because, like, I start drawing and then I realize, oh shit, you can't do anything. Like, you can't do X, you can't do Y, you can't do Z, you can't art. And I know that's something a lot of artists experience, and it's not humbling, but it's sort of like a reality check when you realize even professional artists feel that way. Like, people who have been doing art like their whole lives, people who have it as their career, which I'm hoping to do one day, despite like the masses of demotivation I've had before. But like, these people who have been doing this for years, they still have slumps. They still have days where they can't art. They have days where the whole world seems to be crashing and burning around them because they can't do, like, one little thing. Because they can't put into the page or the canvas or whatever they're using. They can't do it, you know? And it's not just like an amateur artist thing. It's not a, you can't do it because you're an amateur. It's a universal artistic feeling. And it's not just like only art. It can branch out to fucking, it can branch out to like theatre. Like someone's having a theatrical slump, they can't do the character correctly, they can't do the voice correctly. It feels awful because it doesn't feel right. And it's like, anyone who does creative arts or has ever done creative arts knows that feeling. They know the feeling of being in a slump, not being able to do something correctly, and then like mentally bullying yourself because you can't do it. And it's not a good mindset to have. I'm not saying it is, but it's somewhere that everyone in a creative arts has been at least once in their lives. It is a creative block, a slump, a rut. You can't figure out what's wrong, and you're blaming yourself. And it's debilitating sometimes. Like it's not fun. And you don't know how to explain it to somebody else. You don't know how to tell someone else that I can't do XYZ because I just can't. And you don't know how else to explain it. You don't know how to say, like, I don't know, I'm overwhelmed, I'm stressed, I can't do this at the moment. Like, it's not like a deliberate I won't do it, it's a I can't at the moment. Like, it's fucking hell. Did I do an odd number? I did. Damn. Alright. Guess we'll erase that. But it's one of those things, you can't help it. You can't stop it, you can't avoid it. It's something that everyone's going to experience at least once in their lives. And it's painful. Like, this is your passion. You want to do this. You want to go somewhere with this. This is something you want to do. 23, really? All right. But it's like, you want to do it. You want to do it. You want to do it. and you can't. You just can't bring yourself to do it, no matter how hard you motivate yourself. And it's crippling. Because you don't know what's wrong, you don't know why it's happening, you can't figure it out. And it's horrible. Because you're there, and you're doing it, and there's something that's holding you back. And it's shocking to think. Like, you don't ever think about it on, like, a normal basis. Like, it's not something that really crosses your mind. But, like, actors and actresses and, like, artists, celebrities, people who have been doing this for years, who, like, seem to know what they're doing at every turn, and they're in a slump. They don't know what to do. Because for some reason, they just can't get themselves to do it correctly. I was like, even professional artists suffer from art block on occasion. Even if they manage to get out of it quickly, there is still that moment where you're having art block. It doesn't matter how old you are, how professional you are, there will be times when it comes for you that you can't figure out why, but it's there. And unfortunately, that's the reality. That's the reality of it. You're never going to know why. You're never gonna understand unless you, like, properly understand yourself. And if you're going through a time where, like, discovering yourself is almost, like, painful, where it's like, I can't do it, I can't, and you're going through, like, a period of, like, depression or, like, deep anxiety, stress, anything, there can be a number of reasons why you're art blocked, why you can't figure out what you're doing. And it's not your fault. You don't ask to be art blocked. You don't ask to be, like, debilitatingly bored because you can't figure out what's wrong. Like, you never ask for that. You want to be top of your game all the time. But that's life. It's never going to be like that. There will always be those times where you can't. Where the world has beaten down on you so damn much that you want to throw in the towel. You want to give up, and unfortunately some people do. Some people throw in the towel hard. And it feels awful, especially when you've put a lot of time and effort into something. If you're throwing in the towel, it feels like a personal failure. It feels like this is my fault. I was supposed to do good at this. I was supposed to be good at this. And now look at me. I'm throwing in the towel, I'm giving up. And unfortunately that's sometimes how it has to be. Sometimes the only thing you can do is give up. And it's not your fault. If it's not something you want to do, that you have to do, then it is most likely not actually your fault. It is something external. Something out of your control that you can't seem to figure out what. It's a part of life, unfortunately. And that's just how it is. It's awful and debilitating to be giving up. But it also gives you an opportunity to start new somewhere else. And while that doesn't seem great as soon as you've thrown in the towel, and I'm not saying you have to immediately go looking for something new as soon as you have, what I am saying is, despite that, you can still find something to be passionate about, to continue with, to fight for, to, you know, to be there. And it's gonna be difficult. It definitely is. Like, there's no easy way out. Definitely no easy way out. And sometimes the light at the end of the rainbow is pretty fucking far away. But I'm not saying you have to reach for it immediately. You give up, you're down, you're broken. You don't know what to do. Like, if you've just thrown in the towel, you don't have to go. You don't have to search for a new thing to do. You can sit and you can, like, reminisce. And depending on what it is, that could be good or bad. But it's like, if you throw in the towel, think about why. What went wrong with that project or that thing you were doing? Why is it now of all times that you're throwing in the towel when before you could do it perfectly well? Like, you have to think. You have to look back on what you did. If you're quitting out of sheer frustration, then maybe that isn't the thing for you. Maybe in that moment you need something else, something different. And maybe that's good. Maybe you don't have to throw in the towel all the way. Maybe you can just give it a break. You know? Take some time for yourself and, you know, breathe. Give yourself some time and some space from whatever is, like, stressing you out. Because at the end of the day, stress does no good. It's not going to solve the issue. It's not going to make everything suddenly okay. It's gonna sit there and it's gonna fester if you let, like, stress stay. If you continue to stress and to worry and let yourself, you know, think on these things that are causing you, like, pain almost. It's like, is it really worth continuing to linger on something that is hurting you? Like, if to continue this is causing you pain, why would you do that? Why would you continue to be in pain if that's hurting? Like, if you saw someone else in your position, if you saw somebody else struggling with the same things and you weren't. Like, you were fine. Like, if you saw someone in that situation, you'd tell them to stop because it was hurting them, because it's causing them too much stress, that they need to sit back and they need to take a minute for themselves. And the reality of it is, if you're going to give that advice to somebody else, why would you not give it to yourself? Why would you not take that? Why would you tell someone else to take a break, but not allow yourself that same privilege? You're just as human as that person. So, like, take a break. Take some time off. Or just even step away from whatever you're doing for, like, 5 minutes to take a breather. If it's irritating you or causing you pain, stop for a minute. Because at the end of the day, it's not going to help. It's not going to do any good. And, well, what else are you going to do? It's not going anywhere, as far as I'm aware. Oh, wait. Probably have this up. But it's not going anywhere. Depending on what you're doing. But, like, if it is not a life or death situation, like a legitimate life or death situation, take a break. Take a breather. Take some time for yourself. Because you're only causing yourself pain and misery. And if someone else was doing that, you'd tell them to stop. So follow your own advice. Gonna take a while. I gotta go over all of this again. I'll be honest, this is probably a little easier. Just because, you know, I don't have to plan out where I want everything. Everything's already planned out. It's just doing line art. It's a thing you gotta learn, and I'll admit, I'm not the best for following my own advice. Like, I'm saying if something's stressing you out, take a break, and then I'm not doing that. I'm not following my own advice. So, you know, don't take me as a role model when it comes to actually following advice, because I am far from the right person to be doing that. Okay. So this is done, more or less. Like, the actual, like, Andilla part, I just have to, like, go over all of it. Which is fine, it's gonna take a little bit, but, you know. Why are you not... There we go. It's correcting the petals is fine. Like, I'm not too bothered by it. It is a little irritating because they go off, but it's okay. Be like a good premise for a comic, because like earlier I mentioned like wanting to do something like Lavender Town, but at the same time I can't. I'm not like half as good. Like she was drawing like at the very least basic cartoonic anatomy, and I can barely do that. Like, my character has no fucking legs at the moment because, A, you're not gonna see the fucking legs. Not like in the beginning. And B, it's like, I can't draw. Just full stop, I can't draw. Like, it's so self-criticism. Jesus. And it's... I am not cocky when it comes to my art. Like, I am 100% sure there is someone out there who could draw an art piece better than me. There is absolutely people out there who can do it better than me. Which is, you know, it's saddening to, you know, tell yourself that. But it's just unfortunately how things are, I guess. I wish I could stop, but it's like, at this point, I don't think I can. I am a natural pessimist, so I will be naturally pessimistic. It sucks. It absolutely sucks. It's a process. It's not a particularly fun process. 'Cause I wish I could stop, but I can't, and I don't know how. It's like, oh, you just need to be positive. I'm a natural pessimist. I don't see the positives and shit. I naturally see the bad shit. Like, ah, this is crap. Like, I know that it's sometimes going to be a case of, oh man, my art's not good as their art. And then the viewer's like, oh man, two art pieces. Like, it's that sort of thing. But it's still there. The self-criticism is fucking through the roof. I'm also starting to realise how much I swear. Which is kind of like, ooh, man. Why am I using so many swear words? It is a little like, oh boy. What you doing there, buddy? Well, why the aggression? Tell you what, I haven't actually eaten today. I've had a coffee and that's it. It's like my stomach is growling like hell right now. Because I haven't got any fucking There's the swearing again. I haven't got any substance in me. So... if my partner was here, they would be yelling at me. But luckily, they're occupied. They're currently playing Dead by Daylight on a friend's stream. So, I don't have to worry about that. Being yelled at for not eating. It's mostly just a forgetful thing. Because I wake up, I have a coffee, and I'm not hungry. Because I filled myself up with the liquid. And then I get to stream. Like an hour into stream, my stomach's growling because I haven't actually eaten anything today. So, you know what? Just gonna check. Is the stream still going on? Because if it is, I might just... it is. It's still going. Okay, so if I finish this today, which, I mean, it's not unlikely, I might do it. But, like, if I manage to complete it today, I might do a raid to that stream. Just cause. I don't know. There's part of me that wants to pop. Hi, CL. Just, don't mind me. Damn. Ugh. Okay, hang on a second. Okay, never mind. But yeah, I completely lost my train of thought though. Casil came on, and then I completely lost my train of thought. I don't even remember what I was talking about before. I think I was talking about raiding. Probably. But like, you know. We'll see. We'll see. Okay, how much more of this do I have? A significant portion. All right. Great. Fuck. Ah. Okay. Got like loads of leaves. I don't know what to say now. Like, I really don't. I've kind of run out of topics already. See, my life's not eventful, so I don't really have much to talk about. I always end up ranting during these, don't I? Just because it's like absent-minded talking. Looks cool. Yeah. I'm planning on doing like a thing where I do like a big circle. Not like that. But I do like a big circle later on. Like I do a bunch of circles and only colour inside the circles. Because it's something I've done before. I have like a Mandela sketchbook thing. It's a book I got for like Christmas ages ago. And I have this thing where I draw round, like, round objects. Like, I've drawn round a cup, like, the rim of a cup, on the sketchbook and only coloured, like, inside where I, only coloured inside where I drew the circle and left the rest of it blank. Sometimes I colour in the background around, like, stuff black, but I think I'll just leave this, like, plain. For today, like if I do like the circles, I don't do like the background black. I'm currently wearing one of my drawing gloves, my digital drawing gloves. It's working a treat. And it's comfy as well. It's not like a horrible fabric texture. So, it's good. Still kind of funny about the drawing pad though, so I'm not using it at the moment. I should probably switch over to this one, just so I can actually get all the circles in. What is that? Yeah. I recently looked at, like, Lavender Town's, like, comic. I said earlier in the stream, you weren't here though, but like I looked at Lavender Town's comic Unfamiliar, about a witch who moves to like a new town, but her house is full of ghosts, so she has to like help them move on, which is kind of cute. It's got like a cutesy style, because Lavender Town has that sort of cute style, but it's good, and it does have semi-mature-ishy themes, like you know, like people dying, obviously, but it's a good little comic. I watched Muppets Most Wanted yesterday. So I looked at like most of the comic before the movie. Just because we're not allowed to look at our phones when it's movie night. Like, we have to put them down, otherwise Dad gets mad. Unless Dad himself is using his fucking phone, because apparently he's an exception to that rule. Because parent logic. So, like, we were watching Muppets Most Wanted yesterday. It wasn't awful. Like, I have seen it before, don't get me wrong, I'm not that dumb. But, like, trying to think about how they do, like, the Muppets when their full body is on screen or anything. Like, because if their full body isn't on screen, they can potentially hide below the camera line. Like, below the viewpoint. But with, like, full body scenes, like, the number one, number two, like, you're number one, I'm number two, well, whatever. That little musical bit with Constantine and Dominic Bad Guy. Like, that, Constantine is in full frame. So I'm like, they have to be using a green screen. Like, a green screen suit, I mean. So, like, it's an interesting thing to think about. Because I don't quite understand how green screen suits work. Like, I know because it's one solid colour they can edit it out to be in the background, but how do they know what the background looks like if the camera shot is changing? Like, it baffles me for some reason, and I don't know why. Like, I'd love to, like, sit beside someone who works with, like, the special effects stuff, who has to, like, edit out the people in the green screen. Like, I'd love to see that. Like, I'd love to see the process of, like, hiding the green screen suit. Just because it's so unknown to me. Just because it's such a curious topic. Okay, so almost done with the, like, inking of the Mandela, which is great to think about. Because that means I can actually get onto the colouring. Probably not gonna do anything too vibrant. I'll try to keep it, like, pastel muted. Or I could just do vibrant and then, like, change the saturation hue stuff afterwards. But, you know. God, now I've got, like, Muppets Most Wanted on the brain. Fuck me. Okay. I'm gonna do this one here. Are you still on, like, the... Are you, like, doing the Deadline by Daylight stream with Maddie at the moment? Or, like, flipping back and forth? Or are you just here? I think I'll do it with the other one. Just the main bit. I am in call and in stream. Yeah, I thought so. I went into Twitch to like go on the live thing and I saw Maddie was streaming and you said you were dying in Dead by Daylight, so I put like two and two together, so I figured you were in Maddie's stream. I don't mind. It's just funny. It's just funny to me. Because I knew you would be. I just died so you have my attention for a bit. Are you getting better at the game? I can't tell. Muffet's Most Wanted is definitely a little weird. My dad pointed out that 100-something-year-old locket would most likely not disable the high-tech lasers. Like, it may have opened the casing, but it wouldn't have, like, disabled the lasers. I'm probably gonna play one more tonight at most. Well, if Maddie is still streaming by the time, like, I'm done, then I may raid. But if she's not, then I'll just, you know, end stream. And here as well. I believe that's everything. I think that's everything. Now comes the fun part. Now Dota's three. have the feeling someone's going to start hoovering soon. Pretty colours. I love it. Thank you. I'm gonna do that. I think I'm gonna clear it. Clear it. We're just gonna do random without, like, looking. So it's completely randomized. There we go. Actually, I think I'm gonna change it. Cancel. It's this one actually, isn't it? No, it's... Okay, it's this. And then it's, no, have to do this. Zero, zero, midtones, shadows, and highlights. Nah, I'll do like that. Okay. Now we get started on the colours. Yep, someone's hoovering downstairs. Brilliant. Circles, yes, circles. Any other? Yep. I know it looks pretty vibrant, but I assure you it's not. Oh, what I need to do with the circles and that. Need to erase, like, the overlapping parts. Just so, yeah, we only have the outline of where I'm supposed to colour. Any others crossing over? No. Alright. Back to this. We have flowers here. And a flower here. I think I'm gonna go like this one for any of the buds. Okay, and then we gotta go over here. You have my undivided attention. Uh-huh. I don't really know what to talk about, I'll be honest. I haven't had much going on. Talked about most of what I can talk about in the beginning of the stream. And for anyone who's been watching since the beginning, that's kind of going to be a bit of a drone for them. haven't got any new games or anything, which is kind of upsetting. Like, I don't think I actually asked for games, which is probably my fault, but you know. I need to get new headphones because mine keeps slipping off my head. And it's due to the fact that, like, the actual overhead part, the actual strap that's supposed to sit on my head is broken. Like, it's been broken for a fucking while. So, like, I can't fix it properly. Like, I've tried hot glue, and it's got, like, gaffer tape on it, and, ugh, it's horrible. And unfortunately, that means it's slightly malformed. So, you know, it's not fun, really. Gotta do a stretch. I've been slouched for a while. Leaning against a pillow, but still kind of slouched. An early birthday present for me. Oh shit, nuggets. I've been doing it on the red. Ugh, god damn it. Yep. Wrong fucking layer. Oh shit, I moved something. Sorry for being so quiet now, I've kind of lost most of my topics for talking. I would discuss with, like, Dead by Daylight with you, but I've never played it, nor do I really know how to. Like, I don't play a lot of games, because I don't have, like, a Steam account. I don't know how to play Dead by Daylight, nor have I ever. The only experience with Dead by Daylight that I have is, like, watching Maddie's streams, so I'm pretty much like, I don't know, I'm a noob, more or less. Okay. Any other rosebuds? Nope. Do soft green. do like this. I saw the other day. Sorry, I'm like listening. I am actually listening to Maddie's stream right now. Essentially, Forest won the survivors try to fix generators so they can open gates to escape. Killer tries to kill them. Yeah, fair enough. But currently, I'm listening to Maddie's stream, so sorry for not like talking much. Kind of distracted somewhat. I saw a thing the other day. Like, I wanted to watch a video on things you shouldn't do as a VTuber. And it's basically just the things, like, it's not just, like, exclusive to VTubers. It is also, like, it can also include, like, just regular streamers. And I saw, like, the first thing on the video was calling out someone who had tweeted out that lurkers are not valid viewers. And it's like, fucking excuse me? They add to the view count, don't they? They are viewing your content. They are valid. It's like, yeah, anyone who watches like a YouTube video is still a valid viewer, even if they don't like comment or like the video. It's, they are still a very valid viewer. And it's a case of what the fuck? Because lurkers are very much like valid people. They're valid watchers of the content. Because sometimes people put it on as like background noise. Sometimes someone's just in a bad mood and needs cheering up, so they just watch their favorite streamer who happens to be live. They don't intend to talk. Sometimes it's a bit scary to talk in case you like get called out or something, because while it's fun to get your name noticed by a streamer, especially if they're a big one, it's also very daunting, because if they read out your username and then your message, or your message and then your username, or your username at all, like if a streamer reads out your username, then that can be pretty daunting, because you've just been exposed as like chatting and your username's been to the forefront, the streamers recognized you there. And I get it, lurkers don't want to be like the center of attention, and shockingly enough, lurkers are the majority of people that view streams on Twitch. And it's like, why would you call them invalid? Why would you say they're not valid viewers when they're probably the majority of the people that watch your streams? Like, lurkers are completely valid in wanting to just watch and not, like, interact. Because that's putting yourself out there, and some people aren't comfortable with that. Some people just come to Twitch to view people they like that are streaming, that happen to be streaming on the platform. And it's like, why would you like say they're invalid? Why would you say that to such a large group of people? Because that's like tweeting that, and anyone who's a lurker who sees that will then not want to join your streams. They will not want to be a part of a community that like criticizes lurkers for like not interacting. Cause they are interacting. They are interacting by watching the damn stream. That is their interaction. And for some people, that is enough. Some of them are like comfort streamers. Like, UCL said that you sometimes listen to like my VODs as like something to fall asleep to. So like comfort streaming. you know? It's you don't have to interact, like, you don't have to send a message in chat to be a valid viewer of the content. Because what if you have nothing to input? What if you're there just simply for the vibes? Simply to have something there to watch? Because it's someone you like. It's someone you like to watch. It's someone you want to see on screen. And it's like calling those people invalid when they're probably the majority of the people watching you is a far, like, surefire way to lose a huge amount of your viewers. Like, they're allowed to, man. They're allowed to lurk. Lurkers are allowed to lurk. It's a thing. What is that? Like an octopus? That's an octopus. That's a whole ass octopus. But yeah. Lurkers are always valid and welcome in this community. Because I have been there, I have done that, I've experienced being a lurker and being in someone else's chat and not wanting to speak out. Like, put a message in chat. I've been there. Done that, I understand, I feel that. So, anyone who's like a lurker, you're fine here. It's fine. Like, if you wanna chill, you can chill, bro. Is there any of the green before I start the big one? No. Alright. Planned snack stuff when we get back. Okay, it's in the garage if you want to get it. Back at 15. It's all the buffet bits. Okay. Like, I just texted, like, the. We have, like, a family group chat, and it's called Mum's Notices. And it specifically does not have my dad in it. It's just for my mum and my sisters. I'm gonna dip, the sleeps be jumping on me. Alright. You go sleep, babes. You get them sleeps. But yeah. I just texted the group chat to ask if lunch was like planned or make your own. Cause sometimes mum has like a plan for what we're having for lunch and sometimes she doesn't. So wanted to double check, wanted to make sure that like it's gonna be like a planned one so that I don't have to like end stream in a panic because I have to make my own lunch. I mean, actually I don't have to end in a panic. You sleep well, love. From the general like gist of it, I don't think Maddie's still gonna be streaming by the time I finish. Which is fine. It's completely fine. But it's still like Sitting awkwardly, sort of. I may just do this. There we go. This is much easier. Quicker. I will admit, definitely quicker. Damn it, I forgot one. Damn it. Flowers a light blue, just because I think it's nice. Okay. I genuinely don't have much to say at the moment, because it's sort of just colouring this in, making sure all the spots are, you know, filled. Trying to like color the outline instead of like the flower. It does get annoying when it does that. I will admit it sucks when it does that, but damn it. Gosh, fucking darn it. There we go. Interesting. Oh, god damn. The yellow. It's in the red. It's in the red circles. God fucking damn it. Okay. There we go. Okay. Okay, so we need to fill in these. Doing that. Alright then. Acting weird. Maddie's heading to bed. I don't think there's gonna be a raid tonight. I don't even know. This. And we're gonna do that. I don't think I'll raid Maddie tonight, just because she sounds like she's gonna be heading to bed soon. Because she lives in Australia with my partner, not like with them, but they live in the same time zone. And I know that it's pretty fucking late over there. I'll double check it. It is currently almost 11 p.m. Over there, so I don't blame them for wanting to go to bed. So, you know. Deeper purple for these. Gosh darn it. But yeah, Maddie sounds like she's going to bed, so probably won't be doing a raid. It's like, I don't know about doing raids most days. Like, I'm not really a raid type person, especially at my, like, current, my current standing when it comes to, like, the Twitch community. Like, I'm pretty God, what's the fucking word? I can't think of it. Small. Jesus. Why is it so difficult to think of that word? Think the word small. Yeah, I'm a small channel, so I don't really want to do raids very often, since I don't feel I have like an adequate enough base to like I don't think I'm gonna do a raid, because tiny channel, and the person I was gonna raid is heading to bed, so it's like, I'll pass then. Dang it, I did the thing again. It got rid of the UI. It keeps doing that for some reason. Is that just me? Yeah, it's just me. Haven't the faintest fucking clue what I am doing. I'm literally just slamming down colors, because I don't fucking know. Listening to Maddie's stream, like, she is like closing out stream, so yeah. The parents are back. She's currently finding someone to raid. but you know. Doing that. All right, the blue. I need to do it over in the other large one. Pokemon. Is there anything I'm missing here? I'm gonna do white. Oh no, that's gonna be green. Over here. Okay. Okay. I'm missing the middle. Okay, every red circle is filled. Yeah, so Maddie's ended stream, so probably not gonna do a raid. What I'm gonna do though is do like a 2 all over everything. 3 over everything. Just making sure. like that. That looks cool. Yeah, I am happy with that. Holy shit. I'm really happy with that, actually. There we go. Saved. Nice. Okay. So now we transition. There we go. Oh, that was nice though. I like that. It's definitely cute. It's not the worst piece of art I've done. It is far from the worst piece. But yeah, I'm actually really happy with that. Thinking about it much. Just cause it's not really something you should be thinking about too much. It's one of those art pieces where you don't actually really have to think much. Which is cool. I don't mind not thinking. I'm fine doing some head empty art. So not like awful. It's not my best piece of art. I will admit that. It is far from like my best piece of art ever. But, you know, it could have been worse. It definitely could have been worse. And I am a little, you know, a little sad, little tear slipping down my cheek that we couldn't raid Maddie. Even though, you know, she was doing a Dead by Daylight stream and this is an art stream and people really aren't here for the Dead by Daylight. It's, you know, it's all right, it's fine. My laptop is blaring the fans right now. It does not like me. But yeah, it's, I mean, could have been worse. It's actually been pretty drizzly outside, which is why it says on a drizzly Saturday morning. Just, I don't know, man. I feel like it could have been better. Like it could have. It could have been better. But at the end of the day, it's not awful. It is decent. And I'd like it. God, I don't know what else to say. I'm trying to close out the stream and I'm What the fuck? What the fuck? I was trying to do the title thing. Okay, maybe I'll have to change that. I really don't know. I'm sorry about that. I didn't mean to switch things. Like switch costumes. God, I'm forgetting every word in the English language today. But I didn't mean to. But you know. What can you do? Yeah, I have it set on ones I use for like bracketing my bracketing the date, because I do it with square brackets, so I use those ones. I have no idea what I'm doing anymore. Yeah, that was... That was a nice, calm stream, really. Don't know what I'm gonna do next stream. Usually, I don't until either the day before or I panic on the morning. But, you know, we'll figure some stuff out, you know? We'll figure shit out. And, yeah. But, yeah. Stalling to end stream. Yes. But, I hope you all have a good day, week, month, and I will see you in the next stream. Bye!